will be suspended indefinitely. This poll is a release that reveals 78% of junk jockeys don't survive the initial weeks on colony. In 2042 alone, 622 have been lost on the Martian conduit. And the incidence of MRSA and
meal presence
spike way above Earth stats. Let us know what you think, LA. In other news today, USDA
Valentico.
5+ warning for Central Valley. It's going to be high.
Cut 621 expires 052642. That's 4 days from now. Dispatch is good. It's prime.
Kobe. Did you hear it? You and me, cheek to cheek, till the end of time. Pity you didn't take a chance on the long Z. Smoothed out all the creases in you, toe.
Yeah, well, there's too much to do down here. People need to eat. Excuse me.
I'm a little surprised you care. What did they call you back in 28? The apostate? How far you fell?
The human genome is not proprietary. Last night's dip is turned. PL 052042, cut 41. Shelly, I need your numbers. Intersect reference.
What do you have? PL, next up BF, cut 42, previous cut 39, chicken protein. Dip stable, both sides. All sweet meat, good for a week.
Cut 41 is a fail. I'm going to the loom.
How much is down there?
Upwards of 8,000 kilos of 92% pork. Will it render?
I doubt it. It's too far along in the end growth stage. Call 300 milliliters of DNAX. We'll measure photospectronomy on the mother culture. I'll see you in analysis.
300 milliliters of DNAX? I'm gonna need authorization for that, sir.
Log me then.
Order of full fence on 41. Total loss of 8,000 kilos of prime pork loin due today.
Beautiful. It's more precious than life.
How do you feel about that?
I feel bad. It seems to happen a lot these days, and it's just a lot of flesh, a lot of good flesh that's gone to waste. But the loom should be back online in less than 48 hours, so yeah.
That's great to hear. How do you feel otherwise?
I feel fine.
Are you sexually active? Are you lonely?
No.
All good, Tommy, Galvin. You are fine. Please enjoy 250 grams of any Vitro product gratis.
Yeah, okay.
Pick up a recipe card, too. See you in a week.
Okay, thank you.
How was your day?
What'd you say?
How was your day?
It was fine. Did the same sort of usual business. I mostly thought of you.
You're just being silly. Did you know that the ladies of 15th century Spain used heat clay flavored with lavender? Can you imagine that? They ate dirt. These inhalers are always so cold.
Yeah.
But they do make me feel great. I'm almost done. What will you have?
Oh, I was gonna have some chicken.
What does a chicken look like anyway? Feathers, right?
Yeah.
Weird. The egg, too. But beautiful. A symbol of resurrection. I heard that. I think you are too. What's that?
I'm sorry. No, nothing. It's just the kids though. Wait here, okay? Wait here.
Tommy Galvin. I'm Agent Seville of MISWC. This is Agent Walton. Can we come in for an interview?
I'd rather you didn't.
Open the door.
I'm gonna have to ask you to put these on, please. Please?
Why? Is there something inside I should be aware of?
No.
Anything hazardous?
No. I just can't stand contamination. It's just part of my job. Please, can you put them on, please? Excuse me. Excuse me, what are you doing?
Your file indicates you live alone. Is this still the case?
Yeah.
You work at Vitro. 15 years.
Yeah, that's right.
Your psych evaluation suggests there's something up. We also believe you've taken growth hormone from a loom without authorization. DNAX is classified. What do you need it for?
I like to work from home. Can you put that down, please? Thank you. You don't even know what that is.
You're a Gentech. Genetic exploitation is strictly prohibited. You of all people know these implications carry serious federal indictments.
The federal state adjudges such activities as morally reprehensible.
Federal legislation serves Gentech purposes only.
Tell me what's going on. Where is the DNAX?
Can we go to justice, please? I'll tell you everything. Okay? Okay, she doesn't need to know.
She?
Okay?
Who else is here?
Okay.
Galvin, on your knees. Now.
You won't make it.
air so bitter.
Next time.
There is a grandeur in this view of life and its several powers. Having been originally breathed into too few forms or into one. And that, whilst this planet has gone cycling on according to the fixed law of gravity. From so simple a beginning, endless forms, most beautiful and most wonderful, have been and are being evolved.
That car now. It is sand, and with that current, we may never find it.
Yeah, well, all I guess we can do is keep trying.
Thank you. Thank you. Stars. What do the stars look like to you?
Okay, right over here, yeah. I see titties.
I do too. And those are Madonna's titties.
Oh, damn.
And over here, Sharon Stone's titties.
Oh,
and, they're touching each other.
Oh, damn.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
She's got like a third nipple.
Yeah. They're older than us. Madonna and Sharon Stone are older than me and you.
Really?
And they look pretty good. I
mean, they
don't
look
as good
amazing.
As we do, but they look good, you know?
They don't look as good as we do.
I'm thinking about getting back into wrestling shape.
Seriously?
You know, I'm thinking about it, you know?
Oh, wow.
You know, that was a prime, you know, third state high school.
You were good. I will tell you this. You were good, but I could always put you in the half and get you down for the count because no matter what, you could not get out of the wizard.
What are you talking about?
Oh, come on.
Crazy.
You know what? I'll do it right now.
Okay.
I will do it. Come on.
I don't even think you can sit up.
I will do it right now.
I'll give you $100 if you can sit up.
Oh,
once.
Go to hell.
Oh, you're crazy.
But let me tell you something. Now, this is the truth. Nobody threw a curveball like you, and that is something I tell your son all the time.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, you know what? You had a very, very good hook, too.
Well, yes, I could always strike you out with it. That is true.
You did have some fun. You know, I remember working on cars in the garage.
Oh, it was awesome. Yes.
Or the bunk beds we had upstairs, and we pee out the window.
Dad got so pissed.
Yes, because he had to repaint the side of the house with the yellow streak.
The big streak going right down.
And then we'd sneak out there to go see girls.
Oh, man.
Do all that stuff.
And we would get caught, and he would kick the shit out of us.
Yeah, he'd kick the shit out of us whether we got caught or not.
Yeah. Yeah, he was kind of angry.
Yeah, he was very angry.
He was very angry.
Yeah. But we lifted weights in the garage. That's probably why we lifted so much weights.
Yes.
We're getting ready. It was a good day when we take him on.
It was protection.
Yeah.
Yeah, bastard died too soon.
Thank you. Sometimes we get downtime. Because we're the suburbs, we don't get as many criminals as the city does. In our downtime, we crack some jokes. Oh, here, I got an old joke for you. This guy's out in a boat. He's in the middle of nowhere in the ocean. He's lost, praying to God. This other boat comes by. Boaters look at him and go, "Hey, you need some help?" The guy goes, "No, I got faith in God. I'm going to be fine." Pull away, and then a helicopter comes by, sees the guy, comes down. "Hey, buddy, you need some help?" He says, no, I got faith in God. I'm going to be fine." Helicopter goes away. A couple of days, the guy dies. Goes up to heaven. He meets God. He says, "God, what happened? I had faith in you, and you didn't help me." And God says, "I sent a boat and a helicopter. What the hell are you doing here?"
Good. I mean, it's, I'm not God, guys, so I don't know if I'm following the point.
Your husband, wife, whatever, he asked to help you. Your boss asked to help you, your friend Larry. You really want to find out the hard way that that's the only help you're ever going to get?
Oh, divine intervention.
You know, Ted, it's all right not having all the answers. In fact, sometimes knowing that you don't know all the answers is the most important thing, because then you can truly be. But when it comes to your husband, the best part of this job is when I get to ask questions and listen. You'd be amazed how far that'll get you.
Thank you.
Don't be such an asshole.
Turns out, a pedestrian was recording with his phone the robbery inside the store. He posted it on YouTube. Owner identified the thief. The department sends their deepest apologies. YouTube saved you, man.
I've seen you. Your fat ass has.
I hadn't heard that big, but I didn't stand a chance when you took a look at it and started munching.
I called Jack. He didn't pick up. So when I called your dad, they were on the golf course and they insisted I come get
him. Hey, you. Get your butt in the car right now.
You took us off the golf course.
What did I tell you about the goddamn golf course, Teddy? Huh, you little turd?
Hey, where are you going? Get back here!
Out, in, out. What do you want me to do? Where do you want me to go? What are you doing?
Hey, watch it, smartass. Okay, the golf course is sacred. Okay, that is my time away from the world.
Listen to me. I hate the internet. I hate phones. Ever since your mother abandoned us with that guy from MySpace?
His name was Tom.
I told you never to mention his name again.
My bad.
All right?
Yes. Tom will never be said out of my mouth again.
But the internet is a part of our life now. It's an evil that we have to face, okay? It's like anal warts. It's something we have to deal with. And if you don't deal with the internet, son, you're gonna end up alone. And it's gonna be sad. Okay? So here's what we're gonna do. Now you married up. So we're gonna go home and you're gonna apologize. Because you don't wanna lose this marriage because of something on Google? Are you kidding me?
He met someone.
What?
A Latin guy.
Oh, Christ.
Yeah, on Facebook.
Well, then you're gonna fight. Not the Latin guy, because he'd kick your butt. Maybe if he was an Asian, you'd have a chance.
Asian, maybe.
You're gonna fight for your marriage, okay? Listen to me. I didn't raise an asshole, okay? Steve here, Steve is an asshole.
Oh, go to hell, everyone loves me.
Son, let's go home and make this happen, all right? Hey, let's fight for this. remember.
Yeah.
Your guy, he's the best. Son, you're not so bad yourself.
Thanks, Dad.
Hey, yo, listen to me. Beg for your damn job back, okay? Tell them you got that PTSD thing from technology or some bullshit like that because they cannot fight you.
All right, Uncle Steve. That's what I'm going to do.
Okay.
Good idea.
You're a good one, dummy.
Thank you.